Welcome to this month's Ask NCM. I'm Steve Hall at the NCM Institute. Today I'm going to talk about a frequently asked question that comes out whenever I'm either working with service managers or on an end user visit. And this is, do we need a service BDC, and if so, why? This comes up many times, particularly in dealerships that are growing. They've got more volume of calls coming in, and the service advisors are having a hard time handling these, and are trying to figure out, is it most efficient to have a BDC or not? Well, I'm not going to give you the exact answer on whether you deserve a BDC, because that's a very personal choice, and a lot of factors can come into play with it. I will tell you, I am an advocate of the service BDCs, but let me give you the philosophy of why they're so important. First of all, what you're really trying to do is take the incoming service call off of the service advisor's list of items they have to perform. The reason for this is we don't get to plan when calls come in. They come in whenever the customer actually dials our number. Well, a lot of times our advisors are not in the best point of the day in order to be able to grab that incoming call and do a great job with it. They're typically with customers at that time, or possibly away from their desk with a technician looking at a car, trying to figure out estimates or things that way. So what happens is whenever they're with a customer and this inbound call comes in, is they don't know whether they should answer the call and disrupt the customer that they're with in front of, or whether they should possibly let the call go to voicemail and then call the customer back, and there's a confliction there. Many times they go ahead and answer the call. Unfortunately, they rush the call to get off of it because the customer that they're already working with is standing in front of them, and both customers have a disservice. A service BDC or phone call center is designed so that they can take that call, they can spend the appropriate amount of time with the customer, making a great appointment, verifying all information, customer information, along with complaint information on this, and give a great experience. Now, if you have this BDC, you need to make a couple things happen. First of all, the service manager needs to be involved with the BDC. It's not a separate department that they don't interact with. They've got to make sure that they're working with them and that they are keeping them on track for how many appointments they need a day, at what intervals, and training them on how long things take so they know how to schedule. Secondly, you need to have good software that's easy to use for the BDC department so they can run through a script or a flow with the customer and not skip steps on this. Okay? And lastly, you've got to make sure if you take on this added expense of a BDC or a call center, if you want to call it that, that they've got to increase your gross profit. If you're taking on the expense, you've got to get additional increased gross profit in order to offset that to make it viable for your bottom line. If you keep these items in line, you know, in your thought process, I really think that a BDC could be beneficial to a lot of service departments, particularly ones that are in a great growth mode. I hope this helps.